Here we're going to talk about what's called simplifying rational expressions. So when you see an expression like this, your first instinct might be to simplify. So let's see, 4 goes into 24 6 times, and x squared divided by x is x, and y cubed divided by y squared is just y. Okay, so we have simplified that rational expression. And over here, this is a rational expression as well. So to simplify, now it's not as easy as simply crossing off the x squareds, and that's because you can only cancel when you have multiplication. So first, x squared minus 4, that's x plus 2 times x minus 2, and you see why I have multiplication right there? That tells me that these could potentially be canceled. And in the denominator, let's see, it's going to be x plus 2 times x plus 3, factoring that trinomial. And now the x plus 2s can cancel, right? This entire factor cancels with this factor. And I'm left with just x minus 2 divided by x plus 3. Now we can't cancel any further. You might look at this and think to yourself, well, I can cancel the x's, but you can't. And the reason is because x is not attached, if you will, through multiplication. You can never cancel when it's subtraction or addition, only if what you want to cancel is attached through multiplication, like x plus 2 was attached through multiplication right here. Okay, now, what do we mean when we use the phrase rational expression? What's the meaning of that? Let's write this down. A rational expression. All we mean mathematically when we say that is simply a ratio of polynomials. All we mean by that is simply one polynomial divided by another. So in the first example, the numerator had a polynomial, and the same with the denominator. These were both polynomials, right? And for the second example, you had this polynomial up in the numerator and also this polynomial in the denominator. So you might say to yourself, well, isn't a rational expression simply a fraction? And it is, but it turns out there's one important difference. Let's go ahead and discuss that now. It turns out that one important difference can be seen when we compare rational expressions to basic functions. Okay, so looking at that, this question asks us, when is the rational expression undefined? And then we want to simplify. Well, first of all, think of the fraction like, you know, for example, 5 divided by 8. Well, this fraction is clearly defined, and the reason is because the denominator is not 0. But if you see something like this, you know, like, let's say 13 divided by 0, that would be undefined. So a fraction is undefined whenever the denominator is 0. But if you have something like this, you know, 0 divided by 7, that is not undefined. That would be equal to 0. So the one rule for fractions to remember is that the denominator cannot be 0. So when I look at this problem, they're asking me first, when is this undefined? And the way we proceed is as follows. We factor the numerator and the denominator just like in the previous example. So I'm first going to factor out of that numerator a negative x. And when I do that, what am I left with? Well, it's going to be an x because negative x times x is negative x squared. And what does this have to be right here? Well, negative x times something has got to give positive 2x. So that's going to be a negative 2. And in the denominator, that's a trinomial, which I can factor as x minus 2 times x minus 3. Now, I know that your first instinct here might be to cancel right away like we did in the previous example. But when you're asked where a rational expression is defined, you have to do one thing before you cancel. And that one thing is you have to ask yourself, when is the denominator 0? Remember how the denominator couldn't be 0 right here? Same thing happens even when you have expressions containing x. Ask yourself, can this ever be 0? Well, that occurs when x is 2, right? And can this ever be 0? That would occur when x is 3. So when x is 2 or when x is 3, the expression is undefined. Okay, so it's all about when the denominator is 0, and this in the same way it was right here, right? You want to know when is that denominator 0? Same thing here. It's not about the numerator, it's all about the denominator. So the first, our answer to the first part of the question is this, that the expression is undefined when x is 2 and when x is 3. Okay, and then once you do that, then you simplify. So I can cancel the x minus 2 with the x minus 2, and I'm left with negative x over x minus 3. And this would be your answer for the simplification part. But notice that if I was to sort of run through this problem and just simplify and get down to here, and then try to ask myself, oh, when is this undefined? I might mistakenly think that this is only undefined when x is 3. The problem with that is that I canceled x minus 2, and when x is 2, I would have had 0 in the denominator, so I technically wouldn't have been able to cancel when x was 2. So my point is that if you want to figure out when an expression is undefined, you have to ask yourself, when is the denominator equal to 0 before canceling? Okay? Then you answer that question, and then finally you simplify, okay, by canceling. But you always ask yourself about when something is undefined before you cancel. Let me write that down. Before you cancel to answer this question. Okay, let's try another one that is similar in spirit. Okay, we're asked to find the domain of this function. So the domain, of course, is when we say domain, we mean where the function is defined, where f is defined. Okay, so now because this right-hand side is a rational expression, I go ahead and proceed like I did in the previous example. That numerator can be written as x times x minus 4. And that denominator, do you see how that can be factored? What can you factor out of both of these? Well, a negative 2x, and then you're left with, well, it's going to be x plus 4. Let me double check that. Negative 2x times x is negative 2x squared, and negative 2x times positive 4 is negative 8x. Okay, now, when you want to know when the function is defined, right, you have to ask yourself, when is the denominator 0? When is the denominator equal to 0? Well, that occurs when x equals 0, and that also occurs when x is equal to negative 4. Now, the domain would be all numbers except 0 and negative 4. So all real numbers except 0 and negative 4. And why is that? Well, because the domain, remember, is where the function is defined. And 0 and negative 4 cause the denominator to be 0. And if the denominator is 0, that's where the fraction is undefined. Did you follow that? You ask yourself, when is the fraction undefined? And then you exclude those numbers. Okay? So this would be the answer to our question. Now, you can actually go further with this problem and you can simplify, right? Because I can see the x's would cancel, and I'd get x minus 4 divided by negative 2 times x plus 4. So this would be the simplified version of the function right here, but the answer to the question is, well, you can plug in whatever you want except for 0 and negative 4, and you always have to ask yourself this question about the domain before canceling, because with rational expressions, you may accidentally cancel cancel an expression that would have caused the denominator to be 0. And numbers that cause the denominator to be 0 always have to be excluded in the very beginning. Okay? That's how we deal with rational expressions. Until next time.